Live right now on WHIO.com, learn about the beginnings of the historic civil rights organizations mentioned in Letitia's report. And live right now on WHIO TV now, you can watch Letitia's full interview with the Smithsonian Museum's curator. That's a free download on your Roku, Amazon Fire, Apple TV, and Smart TV App Store. McCall, you've been talking all the last couple of days or so about one thing I really don't like to hear about, the snow.
Which is funny because you used to work in Wisconsin and they had a ton of snow there.
It's like I got my fill, though. You know what I mean? Like, I'm good. And yes, I know I complain a lot about the humidity in the summer, but like, I mean, I'm fine with right now. We could stick with this and I'd be happy.
Agreed. It's not so bad right now, but we do have to transition into the winter months and we do have to talk about the potential for snow. So here is what I'm tracking in the Storm Center for the weekend. It will be cool and quiet, so enjoy the next couple of days. Plus, we'll have some sunshine around. That's an added bonus to temperatures close to average. Rain will move in late Sunday and then transition over to scattered snow showers as we get into the day Monday and Tuesday. And then on top of that, we're going to watch the winds picking up, gusting up close to 30 or 40 miles per hour, creating wind chills as well in the teens and 20s. First, let's talk about the weekend. Saturday, 47 degrees for your high. Sunday, we get to 50. And then the high clouds fill in as we head through the day Sunday as that weather maker is getting closer to the area. So let's take a look at Futurecast and that system approaching. Notice at 5 o'clock Sunday afternoon, cloud cover thickening up. Already to our south and west is that rain shield moving closer to the area. Now, rain showers will start to make their way in by 11 p.m. on Sunday. Showers will continue becoming more widespread into the night. Notice by Monday morning, still dealing with a mainly rain setup, and this is an update to what we were talking about earlier today. Then we'll see the cold air that pushes in and we'll see that battleground of rain over to some snow showers during the day Monday, and then officially ending as snow showers Monday night into the day on Tuesday. Now Tuesday we may even tap into some lake effect bands and enhanced snow showers during the day before the system finally pulls away. Now I'm sure you're wondering, how much snow can we expect? Well, perhaps an inch, maybe two at most, for Sunday night and early Monday morning. We'll be dealing with mainly wet and slushy roadways during the day on Monday, not a lot in the way of accumulation at that point. But Monday night into Tuesday is when we'll see a better chance for that additional 1 to 2 inches. So total, perhaps at least an inch, at most we're talking 3 to 4 inches. On the roads, though, that is the main impact, especially through the day Monday. We'll have those wet roadways through sunrise and sunset Monday. Then after sunset, the roads go downhill. Whatever is left untreated will become slick. It will refreeze, plus we'll have that added snow accumulation on top of that. Winds will be ramping up, as I mentioned, creating wind chills on Tuesday as those winds may gust between 30 to 40 miles per hour. So here's the breakdown of the 5-day. This weekend is dry, then that storm system comes in Monday and Tuesday. Highs will still be in the 30s through Wednesday.
Thanks, McCall. This might be my favorite story of the day. A group of garbage collectors in England is lifting people's spirits with an entertaining act that's now gone viral. Now, this all started earlier this year during the peak of England's first lockdown, when they thought people could use a little something to bring a smile to their face. Their videos went viral as they raised money for charity and quickly became known as the Dancing Bin Men.
If they can truly have a boogie around the bins at Christmas, that's what we're looking for.
Oh, that is delightful. And while this group does not get paid for these performances, I personally think that they should, they are hoping that the song they wrote will become the UK's number one Christmas single. I can tell you that they already have at least 2 fans here in the States. With increased need and decreased funds due to the pandemic, the Salvation Army is going high tech. We'll take a look at how the organization is working to help families this holiday season and beyond.